Since 2013, the Royal St. Lucia Police Force has been excluded from U.S. security assistance due to the implication of security personnel in the alleged 2011 extrajudicial killings of civilians. On Friday, U.S. Ambassador to Barbados and the OECS, Linda Taglialatela, announced the lifting of U.S. restrictions on security assistance to specific units within the force and said this is just the beginning of things to come.
I've come here to announce that starting today, we will be able to expand assistance to selected units within the Royal St. Lucian Police Force. After years of review that included consultations across the United States government agencies, as well as coordination with St. Lucia, we have been able to identify a number of Royal St. Lucian Police Force units with which we will be able to resume full cooperation and assistance. This means that those units, such as the Marine and Immigration units, will again be able to enjoy the full benefits of United States security assistance that we are planning to begin as we speak.
Police Commissioner Milton Daisy is thankful for the partial lifting of the 10-year suspension.
We are pleased that Your Excellency has announced the lifting of certain conditions of the lay imposition and has agreed that certain departments in the force will be receiving further assistance. And with that benefit, we hope to continue the good work that we have been doing.
Prime Minister Alan Chastney is happy that the Marine and Immigration units in particular are down to benefit from the renewed cooperation with the U.S. and expects this will go a long way in helping with border protection measures.
Today, we are encouraged by the announcement by the U.S. and I dare say we are already preparing a list of other areas within the security realm where support is needed considering this new framework. I was heartened to hear this morning that $500,000 that had been set aside for our Marine unit will now be available to help upgrade the units that we have, which is very much appreciated.
The Prime Minister vowed to continue to provide all the assistance required to the Director of Public Prosecution's office, charged with investigating allegations of wrongdoing. At the same time, the Prime Minister is mindful of satisfying U.S. requirements without compromising the laws of St. Lucia. The U.S. ambassador made it clear that some departments of the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, especially those in which the alleged breaches of human rights occurred, are still under restrictions.
The Leahy restrictions are still in place on some parts of the Royal St. Lucian Police Force. We have been able to separate out certain units by doing a very detailed analysis, working with other federal agencies and working with St. Lucia to identify areas that can be removed from the restrictions. But they are still in place, and what needs to happen is that we need to continue to look at the other units that we were not able to identify as being safe to work with under the Leahy Law restrictions. And also then to have an accountability of those who have been implicated in the alleged gross human violations, human rights violations back 10 years ago. So it's sort of, we've freed some, but there are still other areas where we need to continue to work.
However, the ambassador has noted progress in bringing the matter to a head. According to her, following the impacts report, St. Lucia has acted on a number of recommendations which have involved restructuring certain departments within the force, clearing the way for the easing of restrictions. The ambassador explained that once the DPP's case is well documented in terms of whether there is sufficient evidence to proceed with the trial regarding the alleged unlawful killings or not, then discussions regarding the complete removal of restrictions can take place. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.